In the day's other news, Saudi Arabia and other Arab states cut off all ties with their neighboring nation of Qatar, sending the Persian Gulf region into a new crisis. They accuse the tiny oil state of supporting terrorist groups and embracing Iran. U.S. military officials said that the crisis will not affect the 10,000 American troops in Qatar. We'll take a closer look right after the news summary. President Trump will not invoke executive privilege to try to block former FBI Director James Comey from testifying before Congress this week. A White House spokeswoman said today that Mr. Trump decided that he wants to, quote, facilitate a swift and thorough examination of the facts. It's been reported that Comey will testify that the president pressured him to stop investigating campaign ties to the Russians. The president today endorsed a push to privatize the nation's air traffic control system. He said he wants an independent organization to oversee operations and upgrade technology, separate from the Federal Aviation Administration. At a White House ceremony, the president said millions of U.S. travelers stand to benefit.
We're proposing reduced wait times, increased route efficiency, and far fewer delays. Our plan will get you where you need to go more quickly, more reliably, more affordably, and yes, for the first time in a long time, on time.
Democrats quickly rejected the proposal. House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi called it, quote, a tired Republican plan that both sides of the aisle have rejected. Tragedy today at an awning factory outside Orlando, Florida. The local sheriff says that a man who had been fired from the plant in April shot and killed five people and then turned the gun on himself. John Robert Newman was armed with a handgun and a hunting knife. Investigators say that he slipped into the giant factory through a rear door. In Mexico, the ruling party held a slim lead today in the race to control the country's most populous state. The PRI's candidate for governor of Mexico State narrowly led a leftist challenger with nearly all the votes counted in Sunday's election. A victory could boost President Enrique Peña Nieto, who has single-digit approval numbers and faces re-election next year. The U.S. Supreme Court agreed today to hear a major privacy case involving cell phone data. At issue is whether police need a warrant to access data about a phone's location. Wireless carriers receive thousands of such requests each year. So far, lower courts have ruled for the police. And on Wall Street, the Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 22 points to close at 21,184. The Nasdaq fell 10 and the S&P 500 slipped 3.